स्टूडेंट, दिस इज माय लेक्चर नंबर 5 ऑफ द टॉपिक सॉल्यूशंस फॉर क्लास 12। इन प्रीवियस प्रीव्यू आई हैव स्टडी द सॉल्विटी ऑफ सॉलिड सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्विंग लिक्विड सॉल्वेंट। दिस इज द कंटिन्यूड पार्ट ऑफ सॉलिड सॉल्यूट डिसॉल्व इनटू लिक्विड सॉल्वेंट, दैट इज अ टेम्परेचर। Temperature, the sum of the compound like sodium carbonate decahydrate NaSCO3 when dissolved into water, the reaction is exothermic process. So that when solute particle dissolve into liquid solvent, then it forms solution as well as heat energy release. So according to Lee Chatelier's principle, when temperature is lower, the equilibrium will shift in that directions where heat energy is released or heat energy is absorbed. In this case, heat energy release, we have to form the solutions so that temperature should be lower. So the reaction takes place forward. But some of the compound like third type compound, some of the compound like Na2SO4 dot NH2O, CaCl2 dot 6H2O tends to CaCl2 4H2O tends to CaCl2 2H2O, etc., which do not affect temperature. In the case of sodium sulfate decahydrate Na2SO4, when upon heating about 32 degree Celsius, first of all it increases the solubility Na2SO4 plus 10H2, and then after the curve which do not affect the solubility when increase the temperature. That temperature is known as transition temperature. It is also known as transition temperature. When we plotting the graph, solubility gram per ml versus temperature, first of all in the case of sodium sulfate, first of all increases and then after it forms saturation point. They do not increase or decrease with its temperature. Na2SO4.10H2. Now we have to discuss the solubility of gaseous solute dissolve into the liquid solvent. Second topic is solubility of gaseous solute in liquid solvent. When the nature of solute particle gaseous volume when dissolved per cubic centimeter volume of solvent, that is in liquid phase, that is known as solubility of gaseous solute dissolved into the liquid solvent. The amount of gaseous solute dissolved in liquid solvent in per cubic centimeter cube at particular pressure, particular pressure temperature is known as solubility. Now we have to discuss what are the various factors which affect the solubility of gaseous particle dissolved into the liquid solvent. Topic is that. Next, factors affecting solubility of gas solute into liquid solvent. First factor is nature of the gases. Nature of the gas solute. Those gaseous molecules whose liquefy takes place easier, then solubility increases. Like CO2, CH4, etc. etc. are examples for enhance the solubility in liquid solvent. But some of the examples like H2O, O2, N2, etc. less solubility in water solvent. So first factor is the nature of the gas solute water solvent. Those are higher critical temperature whose liquefy takes place easier, then solubility increases. Second important factor is pressure. If pressure is high, temperature is low, the solubility liquefaction takes place easier and solubility higher. According to Henry's law, if pressure is higher in gaseous solute dissolve into liquid solvent, then solubility increases. That is, pressure is, let us take example A, that is the solubility of the gaseous particle, gram per ml. Solubility of the gaseous particle is directly proportional to pressure. If any proportionality remove, we have put certain constant value. A is equal to KH into P. This is the first. This is the solubility. A stand for solubility of gas. P stand for pressure. Or KH stand for Henry constant, which depends upon the nature of the gas particle. We can understand of this process if the container is there is gaseous particles, vent piston is placed on it and pressure is increases. Pressure is applied on it so that in gaseous molecules it is a highly disordered arrangements. When pressure is applied, pressure increases, then liquefaction takes place and solubility increases. If pressure is applied on the gaseous particles more than internal pressure, so that solubility increases. Solubility of the gaseous particles increases. Solubility is the pressure high, solubility of the gaseous particle. Now Dalton's modify concept of Henry law. According to Dalton's modification of Henry law, partial pressure of the gaseous solute dissolve into liquid solvent. The partial pressure of the gaseous solute dissolve into liquid solvent is directly proportional to mole fraction of solute. That is P stands for partial pressure, P is directly proportional to X. X is a mole fraction of solute. Then we have to remove the proportionality constant. We have put on certain constant value that is known as Henry constant, KH into X, where P stands for partial pressure, KH for Henry constant, X stands for mole fraction. Now next topic discuss of limitation of Henry law. That Henry law is not applicable. Limitation of Henry law. It is not applicable.